this won't be something that you are aware of. Aaron and I will help you become aware of this. When you start conducting and you start using your score as a crux, it's really easy for us to tell, and here's why. It is a default mechanism for your eyes just to go down as you think about something. You weren't even looking at the score, really. You were trying to focus your mind. It was obvious what you were doing. So in so taking away, I want you to focus on them. You can still think, not a lot. You can still think, but do so by having really awesome eye contact, meaningful eye contact with them. The more you think while you conduct, the less you can hear. The less you hear, the less you can listen. The less you listen, the less you can respond, and you didn't respond. Now, does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, and again, thank you. With someone that you know really well, because I don't want this to backfire. When you're talking with someone that you know really well, and they're talking to you, they are speaking and you're listening, respond more with your face than you normally would have. Now, some of you, I'm guessing, do that a lot already, and you just haven't transferred that to the podium. But some of you haven't. So this is a good way, a safe way, an effective way to practice response in a practical way, a practical manner, okay? Mm-hmm. Here's another way. As you are playing in ensembles, and the conductor, whoever the conductor is, looks at you and gives you a gesture with the facial expression, give the conductor this very same facial expression back. I loved having David Marvel in the wind ensemble because he would always do that from the trumpet. Anything that I would show, he would show on his face. And he got the whole section to do the same thing. It was fantastic. And in so doing, there was a great connection there of aesthetic. Okay? Here's another thing. As you're talking with someone that you know really well, substitute a word with a gesture. So, ask me how I'm doing today. And everybody look up here. Somebody ask me how I'm doing today.
How are you doing today?
Make sense? Okay? Last time?
Yeah.
All right. You need lots of things to think about, but don't think.
Yeah.
Think when you get off the podium.
Brady,
yes.
You write music, and you know this piece really well. So just let what you know of that piece and what you're listening to affect your face.
Okay. I'll try to think about that while not thinking about that while you
know.
default, looking down when people think, looking up when people think, look at them. The more you look into their eyes, the more that they will have the bravery to look back into yours, because the eyes are the gateway to the soul, and that's when you really communicate important things.
One moment where I did look up, and I caught myself even looking up. I was looking back here at the horns, like trying to make some eye contact, but I just didn't get any, so I just kind of reverted to being over here and then looked
over
there.
Okay, notebook. That's a good point. Okay. When you're conducting, you're trying to get in touch with a section or a person, and they're not seeing you. This is a technique that I'll use. I'll wave my hand, and it's totally out of character of the music. But I'm to the point now that I'm ready to get off my podium and get someone's attention, you know? So I don't have the time to do that, because I don't want to have to stop. I want the music to keep being made. So I'll get someone's attention in some way, or I'll just say the word yell, because it really is. I'm not mad, but I loudly say the name of the person or the section, so I get their attention. Then I show them that what I was showing before that they didn't see because they weren't watching. And then I make sure that I respond really clearly to how they respond, because usually they respond really well then, because they, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then I thank them and I go on. I give them a look of, next time watch. And try to do all that as quickly as possible. Because what I'm trying to train them to do is to constantly check in and exaggerate what I'm showing, because nobody wants to listen to me talk. Okay, you're not in an ensemble to hear the conductor talk. You're in an ensemble to play. Last thing, there's some tension in your mouth, yet you're showing and you're counting with your mouth. Notebook. Never count with your mouth, and here's why. That's right.
Natural.
That's why I'm in class. When you count with your mouth, count time with your mouth. Play whether you're doing it. It doesn't matter why you do it. The players will look at that and they will become uncomfortable, because they will think that you are insecure with time. Which, you're a percussionist, you're not insecure with time. Otherwise we'd have lots of problems. So
probably wouldn't be here.
Right, exactly. You'd be someplace else. So never count with your mouth. So be aware of that, and Aaron and I will always point those things out to you. Okay, let's have some comments, please. Let's start.
When you start,
you're up.
Your hands, it's your left hand is not even with your hand or the tip of the baton. It's a little bit lower than both of them. So just